You know, they released Halo 5 recently. And Bungie's no longer with the Halo stuff. But I have a whole bunch of Bungie here. These Halo games. And there's something interesting about these games. Like, you got Halo 1. You got Halo 2. Halo 3. ODST. You got Reach. Anniversary. I have the Master Chief Collection on the Xbox One, and I've got Anniversary, Halo 2 Anniversary. You got Halo 4. 343 did Halo 4. They did Anniversaries 1 and 2. I don't like 343 a whole lot. Because with Halo 5, they have determined that certain things just aren't important. Certain staples of the franchise just aren't important. The gameplay of Halo 5 is decent. I have played it. Please don't, you know, assume I haven't played it. I have an Xbox One after all. The gameplay's okay. But the story, I don't like it a whole lot. It's passable, but that's a matter of opinion. But when it comes down to these two big things about Halo 5, it's not an opinion. It's not me just wanting to be controversial. This is a fact. Why does a Halo game have microtransactions at all? People make their arguments, well, the DLC will be free. I don't care about DLC. Well, you know, we have DLC and we have microtransactions because if we didn't have those, then the games would be ridiculously priced. Would they? I want to know. Because, you know, $60 is a little bit high, but, you know, these games cost a lot of money to make. It's kind of weird, though, when you think about big budget Hollywood movies that I can get for $8 at Walmart. But why are there microtransactions? Why is there like over $1,000 worth of microtransactions in Halo 5? Because I remember back in the day playing video games, I could unlock things. Like, even in Reach and Halo 4, I could unlock stuff by just playing the multiplayer. But, like, I mean way back. Like, you could play a campaign, and let's say you played the campaign and hunted for collectibles or skulls, or you played on different difficulty settings, you would unlock better and better stuff. And now it seems like everybody just wants to do microtransactions. Why make a player play on Legendary to unlock something special when we could just put it behind a paywall and they could give us money for it? Because, you know, that makes sense, right? I mean, it's not enough that we pay over $300 for a console. We buy controllers. We buy games for about $60 a pop. It's not enough that we pay for an internet connection to play for our play with our friends, and it's not enough that we pay for a subscription service to play on the internet connection we already pay for to play with our friends. It's not enough that we pay all this money. It's not enough that we pay all this money, but you guys want to charge us for fucking helmets, for weapon skins. What happened? Isn't that Call of Duty shit? Isn't that Battlefield bullshit? Why is this shit in Halo? Why do we have microtransactions in Halo? Apparently, microtransactions were more important than a fucking staple of the series called Split Screen. Because this Halo 5 was the first Halo ever I could not participate in with my friends. Instead of sitting down with my controller, right here, this is an Xbox One controller, but I couldn't sit down with this controller and play the game with my friends. I had to watch. Why? Why is split screen out? Is it the flimsy excuse 343 has given? Oh, but, you know, if we put split screen in, it would hurt with the 60 FPS and the 1080p. Why is 60 FPS and 1080p such an issue on an Xbox One when the 360 was capable of doing it with games like Rage, Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, Bayonetta? Why is it an issue on an Xbox One? And I don't want any fanboys coming up here, oh, the PS4 can do it just fine. Calm down with the fanboyism. We're talking about this right now. We'll get to that eventually. Why is it an issue on an Xbox One? It's not an issue with the hardware. It's an issue with the developer. If Platinum Games can make every fucking game they come out with a beautiful, smooth, 60 FPS a second, and I know the PC guys are like, peasants. If Platinum Games can make every single game they come out with, then 343, a Microsoft Direct company, should have no issue making their games run properly. And it doesn't even run properly because when enemies get far away, their animations dip significantly. I'm sick of this shit with video games. You guys do nothing now but make excuses and bullshit consumers. We need the microtransactions, otherwise the DLC wouldn't be free. Who cares about the DLC and whether it's free or not? If you want DLC, you buy DLC. That's how it's always been. Since Halo 2, I think. I don't remember. Yeah, Halo 2 had map packs. If you want the DLC, you buy the DLC. But it'll split the player base. Who gives a flying fuck? I'm pretty sure that the people that buy the map packs don't want to play with the casuals that don't get the map packs anyways. I'm so sick of this crap with video games, and Halo 5 is just the latest in a long line of issues that I have with lazy developers and poor standards. It's an Xbox One. The 360. The PS3 could do 60 frames per second. They could. I have games that have it. I put the game in the console, I start the game up, I check the info on my TV, and it tells me what it's running at. There are games on the 360 and PS3 that go to 1080p. A lot of it stops at 720, but some of the later ones, 1080p. But you guys can't make an Xbox One do it, and your flimsy fucking excuse for not putting in split screen, which is a staple of the franchise. Your excuse is it would hurt the 60 frames per second and 1080p. I'm sorry, what? Besides, everybody that plays every other Halo knows that when you're playing in split screen, it does weird things to the graphics to help keep it running smoothly. And we never cared. We just wanted to play with our friends. I mean, that's all I wanted. I just wanted to play a game with my friend. But you have these developers that are lazy or untalented or ignorant. Oh, it's too hard to do. That doesn't piss me off nearly as much as the fans. You have these fucking troglodytes that are like, who plays split screen anymore? That's so 2000. Really, fool? Did you just skip the PS3 and 360 entirely? Because I know plenty of games on PS3 and 360 that split screen. You got Halo. You got Army of Two. You got fucking Fuse. You got Gears of War. You got a lot of games on these systems that split screen. And have been up until the release of the Xbox One and PS4. And even on the Xbox One and PS4, you have games with split screen. Stop making fucking stupid excuses about people not split screening anymore because you don't have any friends in real life. But I can just play online with my friends. Yeah? Let me tell you something right now. Are they really your friends? Or are they fucking people you met in online matches? Because your friends are people you know. And even me. I have online friends and real life friends. I would never take back a single moment I spent playing Aliens Colonial Marines with Patrick. Playing a multitude of games with Kevin. Playing games with Adam. I would never take these moments back. But let me be brutally honest, and I love you guys, don't be offended. Let me be brutally honest. Sitting down on a couch in some chairs with one system, two controllers, a big-ass TV, some beef jerky, sunflower seed soda, sitting down with my friends in real life will always trump playing online with somebody you don't really know. And I love my online friends. But I would rather be able to sit down with two controllers and play my fucking game with my friends. It's to the point where my buddy Adam said, you know, if we lived closer, because I live all the way down here in fucking Bama, and he lives Ohio? I think Ohio. He said if we lived closer, he'd be over every fucking day and we'd just play video games. And that'd be awesome. That's what I want. I want to spend time with my friends. Because there's something so disconnected about talking into a headset and playing online. Not to mention the fucking costs. You know how much it costs to do that? If I wanted to play with Taylor, all I'd have to do is go buy another $60 video game, buy a $60 12-month, because buying anything less is a waste of money, Xbox Live Gold subscription, and drag my fucking HDTV to his house, hook up to his internet, get all that shit set up, and then be like, can you invite me? As opposed to pressing a button on a second controller and signing in. It's just an excuse to sell another copy of the game. It's just an excuse to sell more systems. That's all it is. That's all it's ever been. It's about money. It's not about fun. If they wanted you to have fun, they wouldn't have done it like this. But they don't want you to have fun. They want you to give them more money. And the fucking troglodyte fanboys, who plays split screen anymore? I do! I like split screen. What, are you too fucking good to play with your buddies on the same TV? If that's such a problem, then they should bring back System Link. Because that's what we did with a lot of games on the 360 and PS3. We'd get another copy of the game for cheap and we'd System Link it. Or it'd be a game that we both already had because we both liked the franchise and we'd System Link it. But no, they don't want you doing that. They want you to buy that Xbox Live Gold subscription. That's why Halo 5 has no offline modes besides the campaign single player. You can't even do custom games. Do you guys know how many memories I made with friends playing just a custom game? I made a map on Halo 3 Guardian, and all I did was edit it and put some more explosive coils around. I took almost all the really heavy power weapons off of it, and I put a shotgun in the center of the map. You know what the name of the game type was? My Shotgun. The whole point of the game is get the shotgun, keep the shotgun for as long as you can. We didn't even care about kill counts. We didn't even count that shit. We put it on infinite kills. We just tallied up the time. How long have I had this shotgun? And when we lost the shotgun, we'd kill each other a little bit till it respawned, and then, hey, my shotgun. That was a great time. I had fun with that. Can't do it on Halo 5, though, unless I pay for that subscription and drag my shit to his house so we can play together. But Brett, why don't you just get a subscription, get a copy of the game, and play at your house? Because it's a lot more fun and involved when you're next to your buddy. You know what happens online when your buddy, you know, assassinates you? Aw, you fucking asshole. You know what happens in person when your buddy assassinates? Aw, you fucking asshole, and he's sitting there laughing his ass off. You can't do that online. You can have a lot of fun online, don't get me wrong. But playing with your friends on a couch on one TV is vastly superior. Vastly superior. So I'm irritated with Halo 5. I've decided that Halo 5, for me at least, is going to be a used purchase. Unless somebody sends it to me, or, you know, whatever. I'm not getting Halo 5 for $60. Halo 5 is not worth $60. Maybe $30 for the campaign. Still can't play with my friend. No, Brent, you can. You just need to buy. Shut the fuck up. I don't need to buy anything extra to play with my friends. If I really want to play with my buddy, guess what? I'll just take Halo 4 and my 360 over to his house and we'll play that again. You know why? Because every single one of these fucking games, every single one of them has split screen. Even Halo Wars has System Link. But that is apparently not so important to 343. No, microtransactions are important to 343. Fuck 343! Fuck Halo 5, and fuck the dumbass fanboys that fall for this bullshit. I'm out.